Hello everyone. This video will explain how to create a live looping template using only Ableton Live, a Launchpad, and the instrument of your choice. Here we have an audio track routed to input 2 of my audio interface, and its output going to a group channel called Group Blue, where we have a filter, delay, and reverb ready to go. I recommend a new group channel for each instrument you wish to add to the template. First, we're going to add the looper plugin to our audio input track. Next, I'm going to set up a MIDI track for what I call a visual metronome, which will light up some indicators on a QompleteKontrol keyboard we'll be using. This track is an optional step, but should be configured with no MIDI input and its output going to the controller. Now, I already have a clip I'm going to paste from my clipboard for this visual metronome, which contains MIDI CC data I've set up in a square wave shape on the quarter notes. You can take a closer look at this when you download the template. Next, I'm going to set up the MIDI track for the instrument we'll be looping, which only applies if you're choosing to include MIDI looping with your audio loops. Configuring this track will vary with your setup, but in this case we'll be using a zero coast from Make Noise. Next, we'll set up our first track used for looping audio, and its input will come from our audio input channel from before, and its output will go to the blue group. I'm going to move these looper channels all the way to the left of the screen, and then I'm going to duplicate this audio loop channel 6 more times, which will basically fill up all 8 channels of a Launchpad with 1 MIDI loop and 7 audio loops. In the Preferences menu under Record, Warp, and Launch, you're going to want to disable Exclusive Arming, set Default Launch Mode to Toggle, and Default Launch Quantization to Global, which in this case is set to 1 bar. Now we're only going to arm the looper channels. And we're only going to monitor the audio input and the group channel. The MIDI channel is set to auto, and all looper channels are set to off. Next, we're going to map some controls to the audio looper. And since I never use the row buttons on the side of a Launchpad, I'm going to use those. I also prefer to have the looper go into playback mode after recording, rather than overdub, which is indicated by the green play button in the looper plugin. Here we'll map the record button on the looper plugin to the bottom right button on the Launchpad. We'll map stop to the second from the bottom. And clear will be mapped to the third button. After you're done mapping, you can save your work and you're all ready to go. First, we'll start by recording a loop into the audio looper. And when we press record again, Ableton has determined this is a 4-bar loop at around 102 BPM. At this point, I like to record the looper audio into one of the clip slots. Then we'll stop recording the clip while simultaneously stopping the audio looper, giving us a nice smooth transition to the clip playback. And we can also start recording our next loop, too. At this point, we're done with the audio looper plugin, and here you can see the visual metronome working on the keyboard. Now we'll stop recording this loop, which puts it in playback mode. Now let's try recording a MIDI loop, where we have global quantization set to 16th notes. There's a slight hesitation there. I was making sure the volume was down on the synth so I could fade it in. Now one of the obvious advantages of recording a MIDI loop into a synth is you can tweak it while the notes are playing. And we can also record this into an audio loop. Just remember to stop playback on the MIDI loop when you finish recording the audio loop. And here we'll record one more audio loop. There's a few different ways you can get a visual metronome working. An extra Novation Launchpad can receive patterns of MIDI notes, which will always follow the tempo of your first loop in the audio looper. Right now the Launchpad is in User 2 mode, and all of these MIDI metronome clips will be included with the template if you'd like to look inside them and see how they work. Since my second Launchpad is usually used for more looper channels for additional instruments, I also use a MIDI Fighter 3D for its LED feedback. I find the visual metronome to be the main thing that eliminates any need to have to look at a computer screen during a performance. So I hope you find this demo useful for building your own template. This is something folks have been requesting for quite some time. And also, feel free to leave questions in the comments, too. Check the link in the description to download two versions of this template, one with the audio loops from the demo, and one blank template to start looping right away.